Hello, everyone. We think that we found an efficient way of automatically increasing version numbers and linking them to our code base. We also think that it can be done for any application written in any language in any ecosystem. My name is Pavel Rogovoy, and I'm a software engineer at Final. I'm also a creator of an open source utility called Vmn. This utility is written in Python, and we are going to talk about it today.
Hey everybody, my name is Ron Shilo. For the past 6 years, I've been a software developer at Final. For the past 1 year, I've been a core maintainer in the Vmn open source project.
In order to understand why we've created Vmn, let's take a look at the standard development process of any application. First, the developer initializes a Git repository. Then he writes some code, he tests it, and now hopefully it works. Now what's left to do is to stamp the version and release it. Ron, every time you stamp an application, what particular questions come to mind?
Well, Pavel, to be honest, the first thing I always ask myself, is there a standard way of doing it?
Well, it's a great question. And yes, there is a standard way of doing it. It's called SEMVER. And Vmn helps you stay compliant with it. Are there any other questions that come into mind when you stamp a version?
Yes, there are other questions. I work with jar files. I work with pip packages. I work with CPP code. Does Vmn support all these things?
Well, yes. Actually, Vmn supports all these things because it saves the version number in a very generic way. Vmn assumes that every application has its code base and it utilizes it.
Okay, let's get our hands dirty with a real-world scenario of how to install Vmn and how to use it for stamping. We're going to go to github.com, and in the search bar, we're going to type in Vmn. There it is. Let's click on it. And let's scroll down to the installation instructions. There they are, pip install Vmn. That's pretty easy. Let's fire up the terminal. We're going to create a virtual environment. There it is. And now we're going to run pip install Vmn. Let's check the version. And we have a good installation. So far, we've created a virtual environment and installed Vmn. Let's get back to the GitHub page and check out some basic usage. So for this part, we're going to need a repository with some source code and an application that we'd like to stamp. Luckily, I have one ready. Let's try it out. We can see that this is a Git repository, and inside it, we have a Python file named myapp.py. This will serve as the source code for this demonstration. Now, let's run Vmn help and get back to the manual. For the next step, we'll run Vmn init. This will initialize Vmn across a repository. No matter how many applications we have in the repository, Vmn will support all of them. We have successfully run Vmn initialization. Let's take a look at our directory now. After initialization, Vmn will create the .vmn directory. This holds configuration files and other information that Vmn requires. We have successfully completed this stage. Let's return to GitHub and resume the manual. So it looks like we've completed all our preparations. We've run Vmn init and are ready to stamp our first application. Let's get back to the terminal and run Vmn stamp -h to see all the stamping options. So the first flag we can see is release mode. Vmn supports a major, minor, patch, or micro version. In addition, we have the starting version option. This is useful if you've already released your application with a version and you simply want to use Vmn to continue from that point. So, let's release a minor version of my app. And since this is the first time that Vmn is doing this, we're going to tell it that my app has been released in the past and its current version is 1.14.0, and we want Vmn to continue from this number. Well, all done. Vmn has released version 1.15.0 of my app. And from this point on, we will not need to enter the starting version, as Vmn will remember my app. Let's get back to the usage page and see what other options Vmn offers. Vmn show can give us additional information about the state of our repository when the version was stamped. Let's give that a try. For a standard application, VMN show will reveal the current version of the application. The verbose option will show us more information, most notably, the Git hash that was used when the version was stamped, the remote repository location, the release mode, and the stamped branch. A useful trick is saving this output into a file and then using it either in a Python package, a Docker image, or any type of binary packaging. The final VMN feature I'd like to show you is the go-to. It will easily allow you to navigate your repository between different versions of your application. Let's give that a try. So for this, we're going to stamp my app with a new version. And for that, we need a new feature, something like print hello, PyCon Israel 2021. Let's commit the changes. And as this is a small change, let's release a patch version. Success. And let us notice two things. Number one, I did not have to use the starting version flag. As I've stated in the past, VMN is already familiar with my app, and from this point on, it will manage its versions. The second thing is, VMN has successfully released a patch version of my app, bumping up my app from 1.15.0 to 1.15.1. Okay, a quick recap. In this version, my code prints out hello PyCon Israel 2021. Now we're going to go back using the VMN go-to. We're going to type in VMN go-to version 1.15.0. Okay, and let's look at our code again. And surprise, surprise, it says hello world, nice to meet you. Just as it was before we introduced the new feature. So now let's move forward or back, depending on your perspective, to version 1.15.1. Let's look at the code again, and there it is, the new feature. So, in the same way we use Git to navigate between branches, commits, or manually added tags in our repository, we use VMN to navigate between application versions. This sums up our tutorial about basic VMN usage. Please visit our GitHub page for more information. Thank you. Thank you for staying with us. We've just completed our first tutorial of how to use VMN in a Git repository. We've stamped an application, we've incremented its version, and we have navigated through the version history. VMN can do all these things because it supports internal Git objects. So we can get versions off of branches, we can merge versions, and we can collaborate between developers. VMN can also support a collection of services that are bundled up together into a virtual application. That's something we like to call a root app. Let me take you through a tutorial to explain to you what advantages VMN can offer in this field.
Oftentimes today, an application can be defined as a collection of individual services. VMN also supports this type of stamping. Let's take a look at VMN's webpage on GitHub. We can see under Advanced Features, Root Apps. This means that every time a subservice is stamped, the parent root app service is incremented. And when you have a collection of services, the root app will increment every time one of the services is stamped. Let's give it a try. I'm currently in a directory that has two services, service 1 and service 2. Let's stamp service 1 as part of a root app named My Root App. Now, let's stamp service 2 as part of the same root app. Let's review the stamps we have just created. Service 1 is at version 0.01. Service 2 is at version also 0.01. Now, My Root App represents a collection of services, Service 1 and Service 2. Every time each of the subservices gets a version, My Root App is automatically incremented. let's see how we can find out what version my root app is on. Reviewing the help menu, we can see that there is a --- root option. Let's try that. We can see that my root app is at version 2 because it has been incremented twice. The first time when service 1 was stamped, and the second time when service 2 was stamped. Let's see what happens when we restamp one of the services. Let's make a change to service 1 by giving it an update. And let's test the change. Now we need to commit our changes. Now that the update has been committed, let's release a new version of service 1. Service 1 has been bumped up to version 0.1. Now, let's review my root app version. My root app has been automatically incremented by 1 and is now at version number 3. It does not matter what size the increment of any one of the services is, the root app will always increment by 1 for every change of one of its services. This concludes our tutorial regarding root app stamping. For more information, please visit our GitHub page. Thank you for watching.
We've just completed our second and final tutorial for this lecture. With the root app feature, we have successfully tackled the challenge of managing complex service-based applications.
Very interesting, Ron. Let me tell you about how we use VMN today. And let me tell you about some exciting new features that are coming in the next near future. Today at Final, we use VMN for most of our production systems. Our systems are written in C++, Python, and some other languages. But not just applications need to be version stamped. We use VMN for our DevOps deployments that are written in Ansible or Salt. Let me tell you about some exciting features we plan to introduce to VMN in the near future. We would like to be able to visualize our stamping history, so it will be clear to the user what version was stamped on which branch. In order to achieve that, we will create a graph that will display exactly that, just like Git does with repository history. The auto release notes feature is meant to reduce the release overhead from the developers, so that the version will be automatically linked with the features it introduces. By collecting the commit messages, we will be able to generate a release notes draft that will be later modified by the user.
VMN is an open source project, and you're welcome to use it for your version tracking needs. We are a growing community of developers, and user inputs are always welcome. Also, we'd appreciate code contributions.
We would like to thank the community and our amazing users,
especially PyCon Israel, for hosting us here today.
And we would like to thank Final for supporting the community and its work. If you'd like to come and work at Final on other exciting projects,
Final is hiring.
Please visit Final's website and apply.
Thank you for attending this lecture.
Thank you.